If you need a roadmap in crypto and you need to make money in crypto, then you want to take a look at our sponsor, tokenmetrics.com. VeChain. Ah, oh, God. Really thought this thing was going to go at 17 cents. What happens when you FOMO? You NOMO, and it goes down. Now, if VeChain goes to 10 cents, that literally would be a gift from Santa. I don't know if that's possible, but I'm still a VeChain fan. And if they mark it down on a discount, Black Friday discount, I'm still a fan of VeChain, even though I have to admit I FOMO'd. Everybody FOMOs in crypto sometimes. Okay, Gala. Support at 35 cents. Looking at these candlesticks, what happens in these trades, these momentum trades? They rally. Everyone takes profits. It comes back down. Nothing wrong with that, right? Nothing wrong with traders selling, providing liquidities to people who want to hodl for months or years. So if you see a candle where it like wicks up and comes all the way back, it's not the end of the world. It isn't. Right? It gives you these dips to buy. In the case of Gala, it hits 35 cents, right? You know, it looked like it was over, but then, you know, it pops back again. And if it comes off, if Bitcoin gets hammered below 50, as long as 35 cents is holding, 55 cents is possible. So in these momentum plays, the key is, I think, to have a small position in the things that you like, and then the willingness and the capital, and the fortitude to be able to jump in if either a Bitcoin rally or a Bitcoin decline gives you a shot at buying altcoins. Because as Forrest told you, folks, what instrument in this market has not taken out its 2017 high? The 2017 high in Ethereum was like $1,400. It's now at 4,000. So how is altcoin dominance not going to take out its 2017 high? In my not so humble opinion, it will. So that's why you look at Gala, you look at support and resistance points, and you get involved when you can. Okay, Immutable X, our fundamental guys were all over this when it came out. Immutable X down to support around $7 when this chart was published. That's a good support point. So if Immutable X is above $7, okay, there is a chance for material upside. Again, what happens if this whole space undergoes market cap expansion seen by Compound, Chainlink, and Theta, right? All of those coins during the day, during their day, went materially higher. Is Immutable X in that category? I don't know. Is Immutable X in the category of the metaverse that could just take off? NFTs, et cetera. Yes. Okay. Now, Decentraland. I guess you could call this your dad's metaverse because it's on Coinbase. But here's the deal, folks. At four, there's resistance. So we're going to play this game probably where it consolidates in and around four. But what should you do? Should you do what's worked all year, perhaps, and buy the dip below four, knowing that if everybody comes in and FOMOs in all at once when this correction is over, right, Decentraland could go from 4 to 6.5. Now you're like, oh, well, I missed it. It went from 50 cents to $4. Yeah, okay. So what? Now what? Right? A consolidation below four for a possible move to 6.5. If this is one of your metaverse holdings, at least you're involved. Now, if you don't want to do Decentraland, ask yourself this question. What's better? What makes you feel better? Owning Decentraland or owning Facebook? You want the decentralized metaverse or the centralized one?
Token Metrics is a cryptocurrency investment platform that helps users leverage machine learning to become better crypto investors. Our in-depth analysis helps eliminate the emotions of investing, find profitable investment opportunities, and filters out scams. Learn more at tokenmetrics.com.